it's spitting. It's I can see spitting.
Dear. Oh no.
What a disaster. This holiday in Greece is ruined.
Ruined, yeah. Oh, here
jump.
It comes. Say goodbye to your visibility.
Oh
dear. I assume.
It's really rolling in.
Oh no.
Oh my god. I can't
see sorry about it, onlookers.
I've got two words for you.
Right.
Thunder snow.
Thunder snow? Yes!
So intense. That was the flash
of lightning.
Oh, is
that thunder snow?
Yeah.
There we go.
Hello, welcome to Outside Xbox and to the Xbox One X version of Dirt 5. Now, obviously, there is a Series X version of this game arriving in just a few days, which is going to add extra graphical pretties and extra performance, but we couldn't wait around for that because we have an extreme weather challenge.
Extreme! Mike's doing the extreme weather challenge.
Yeah, I'm going to be doing it. Jane is helping, moral support.
I'm here in an observational capacity. I'm your co-rally driver. I answered
an ad. And adjudicator,
yeah. And then, I turned up. I have no experience, obviously, in rally
That's
driving.
Fine.
But
you just answered the newspaper.
Yeah, I want it enough, I think.
Yeah,
that's my qualification. So let's see some extreme challenges, some extreme weather.
So we've got six races, each with increasingly extreme weather that I'm going to have to tackle, culminating in the most extreme weather that Dirt 5 has to offer. So we're going to see how I get on. The first one is this one on Lion's Head, South Africa, which is not so much a weather transition, but a transition from day to night. So it's nice easing in to the
That's
kind of dynamic weather and time.
Extreme or weather, day to night.
No, but I need the warm-up, okay? So we're going to do it. Okay,
how do you feel?
I'm feeling
focused, refreshed?
Confident, focused, and refreshed at the moment, but I'm worried about some of the more extreme weather conditions I'm going to be facing.
All right, well, I'm going to sit back and relax, and you too at home should sit back and relax and enjoy Mike's proficient driving, I expect, in this video brought to you by Outside Xbox and sponsor Dirt 5.
Yes, here we go. There's already been a massive accident, Jane.
What the heck are you even driving? Is it some kind of souped-up tractor?
It's a sort of weird Jeep with kind of paddly tyre type things for paddling through water, I guess.
But okay, it's an amphibious tractor.
I think if you drove this fast enough over a lake, Jane, you could drive literally over the water like some sort of Jesus.
Oh, okay,
so,
that sounds fun.
I think it's the sort of thing they do in Iceland for kicks. They basically drive these things across lakes. To show off, I guess.
All right.
Ooh, I'm already in the lead, but I'm also completely sideways. So, look, here we go. There's a different route. I'm going to take this route down to the right.
Oh, is it a shortcut? A faster track. Okay.
So, you know all these serious racing games I make you guys watch?
Yeah.
Well, this is a racing game with shortcuts and things.
Oh, man.
So it's not taking itself too seriously.
Okay,
obviously.
All right.
And we're here in South Africa. We're racing. Oops, I'm sort of grinding around the railings there, but it's fine.
Yeah.
So we're racing up a mountain, basically. And as you can see, we're being treated to a lovely sunset. It's going to get dark very, very quickly.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
I assume it gets dark quickly around the equator. I don't know. I'm not a geographer. I'm not a racing driver either. Really, but at the very least, in Dirt 5, it does get dark very, very quickly.
Yeah. Well, you want to see the sunset. You want to see
exactly.
The full dynamic range of day to night.
Yeah, I'm absolutely tonking these guys. I should spend a bit less time looking backwards and a bit more time looking forwards. But
even on this uphill climb.
Yeah. Oh yeah. But you get to see those nice transitions from sort of day to night. Oh,
there's
I've really
those classic hot
up.
Air balloons.
Yeah, you've got to have them in a racing game.
You've
it's not
dress
a racing game.
Into the sky, right?
Unless you have a hot air balloon.
What
normally
else are you
going to
put in the sky? Really large
well,
birds.
Look at this. Look at this lovely view of Cape Town down there. I assume that's Cape Town. Again, not a geographer, but look at the stars as well. Lovely.
They only pay you to drive, Mike.
That's true.
Geograph.
And there's the moon. That is the verb, isn't it? The geographers, they go around geographing, they graph the geos.
Wow, you're right. It does get dark fast here.
It does, doesn't it?
On the mountainside.
Also, I've been caught up a bit by my competition. There they are. Oh, no!
I spent too much time
looking backwards.
You gave those onlookers a bit of a scare.
I did. I'm going to have to do a lot to recover now. Right, here we go. Let's chase these guys down. Oh, I'm colliding with rocks and everything.
Wow. It's getting dicey here on the mountain.
It certainly
not
is.
There's a lot of light.
Oh, they've
oh,
a
wow,
fireworks
the Milky
display,
Way's
though.
Up there. Yeah. Fireworks. Wow, they found more stuff to put in the sky. Much respect. but that's the Milky Way. I can see it. Like, glimmering away.
I suspect the lack of light pollution out here in this corner of Africa probably is a real treat for stargazers.
Yeah, except for the fireworks, of course.
Yeah, and also the rampaging off-road racing that's going on at the same time.
That's fine.
Seventh. Not a good start in the challenge, but
you had it and then you lost it.
I had it and I lost it. Yeah, exactly. I got cocky. All right. Well, we're gonna have to step it up, though. We're gonna have to step it up to a rainy race. How about that?
Okay, that's
and some different
extreme
machinery. Yeah.
Let's get some weather in this extreme weather challenge.
But, you know, as a British person, I feel like rain is my natural habitat.
That's your safe zone, your comfort area.
If I don't win this one, I've really, really embarrassed myself.
Okay, fine. Are we going to be using the paddle tyres?
No, no paddle tyres for the rain.
No.
That would be cheating.
No.
Here we go. Sisyphus Struggle is the name of it.
Oh, okay. Very classical.
Because it's in Greece. It's in Greece.
I see. Yeah. Are there going to be Medusas?
Yeah, and
I'm going to be pushing
a rock up as well. Yeah. There's Medusa with a stylish eye patch.
Yeah.
Weather looks nice at the moment, Jane. I can't imagine it's going to rain. I mean,
it's not that there's no cloud in the sky, but they don't look like
they're
old gloomy rain clouds.
Exactly. So it'd be really unfortunate if it started to rain, really. I think quite unlikely.
Check the forecast, no rain. Sorry, what are you going to say?
These you will recognise as modern rally cars,
yeah,
basically.
Yeah, that's more like it. That's what I expect to see.
Exactly, yeah.
That's what I signed up for.
So this is what you might more regularly associate with a dirt game. But yeah, they are in there, and I've got myself a little cheeky little Ford Fiesta R5 to throw around the place.
Very nice.
But there's no sort of regular rallying. It's all races, so it's all kind of door handle bashing and full contact racing in this game.
Very cool.
So yeah, it's pretty chaotic. It's very much an arcade game rather than, you know, Dirt Rally 2.0 was very hardcore rally simulation and stuff. Well, that game takes care of that stuff, and this one's a bit more of a kind of knockabout, play on a controller type thing.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I find the sim stuff fun as well, but I recognise that.
I know you do.
It's not your bag.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look at that beautiful, beautiful handbrake turn. Oh,
it's
starting to drizzle, Jane.
Come on,
it's
starting to, Halliday.
It's spitting. I can see spitting.
Dear. Oh, no.
What a disaster. This holiday in Greece is ruined.
Ruined, yeah.
right, okay. Well, I'm doing well, though. I'm doing okay.
I noticed we're climbing again. Is this a theme?
Yeah, there's
uphill
a lot of hill climbing.
For
and
sure.
It's a lot of these courses are sort of really dramatic areas of the world. So there's this sort of, obviously, Africa, there's Greece, there's places in Norway as well. There's a giant marble quarry in Italy that you race around,
Fun.
Which is quite cool.
Okay, so you want dramatic vistas.
Yeah, it's all about dramatic vistas and even more dramatic weather.
Okay.
And the rain is really starting to come down now. Uh-oh. It's not really affecting the surface as yet. But if it continues to rain,
it might start
to get a bit muddy,
and
a bit
slippery.
Here we go. Let's see if I can hit that helicopter off this jump.
Extra points. Bit short.
But look at that crazy monastery up on a big rock.
I love it.
Some really interesting locations that you don't necessarily see in like other racing games.
So we're racing up to the monastery, to the rally monks.
Yeah, I guess the sacred order of rally monks.
Yeah. We're on a pilgrimage to the rally monks.
They've taken a vow of silence, apart from
the
co-drivers.
Taken a vow of rallying, yeah. Wow, that is a low hovering helicopter, getting some sick shots.
You've got to get the pictures.
Some aerial shots.
You can see the surface is starting to get slippery now.
It's starting to slide around.
Yeah, there's puddles.
Oh,
there we go. It's getting real gloomy.
Need my paddle wheels.
Well, the weather's turned on a dime. Oh, lightning as well.
No, forked lightning. Oh, Zeus is real mad here in Greece today.
He's, What did Zeus do?
To Zeus?
Cast
Why is he trying to zap you?
The weird thing about Zeus is that he's the lightning god, but he's also the god of, like, coming down as a cow and romancing people and things.
He's
got a real weird vibe about him, Zeus. I'm not sure I like it. He contains multitudes, that Zeus.
He's a... yeah.
Here we go.
Many hobbies.
Fireworks and confetti.
Oh, very pretty.
There you go. I knew I'd get the rain race under my belt.
Yeah, no problem whatsoever. God,
it
turned muddy fast though.
It really did. Yeah, look, these guys have their cagoules on though. They came prepared. There you go. Everything's absolutely filthy.
I suppose it's my job to clean this car now, is it?
Yeah.
Get the mud.
Yeah,
off.
That's part of the co-driver's role.
It was in the job description.
In the newspaper article, you'll have noticed it said
it's mostly
you get to
about
clean
cleaning down the car afterwards.
Okay, Jane, here we are in Brazil for a race in the immediate aftermath of quite a lot of rain. So it's extremely muddy.
Okay.
I'm in some sort of ridiculous go-karts thing.
Speedboat on wheels.
That is about there's a fraction of the size of the things.
Oh,
I'm
you're dinky! In. I didn't realise how dinky you were going to be compared to these other giant buggies.
Look, I've got a little spoiler though. I can do it. I'm the little.
Yeah, you could like
the rally car that
you could dart through the pack with that narrow little buggy.
Yeah, but it's
adorable. I mean,
it's not raining right now, but it has recently been raining and it is extremely
mega muddy.
Yeah,
heckin' so muddy out here.
I think this counts as an extreme weather challenge.
Yeah,
entry,
mud is
certainly
a kind of weather, if you
Yeah, it's just
believe.
Weather on the ground. Oh my gosh, that was a massive
no.
accident.
Oh
I've
no,
done a big
you're in the jungle. Oh, you're right in the rainforest,
okay,
facing the wrong way.
Get out of this rainforest.
Oh no.
That was a huge accident.
That was bad. Go-kart.
This is mud is already causing me big problems, and it's only
Do you
getting
think
muddy.
You can
Although
catch up?
There were two other cars crashed in the forest there as well, so I'm not alone.
Okay.
Right. Yeah, I think I can catch them up. Let's give them a look. Here are we're racing through the sort of favelas of Brazil. And
yeah,
things.
Your dinky little wheels.
Yeah,
how are they going to cope?
They're not coping particularly well.
No.
I don't have a lot of grip. And the engine sounds like it's screaming. Absolutely screaming at the moment.
Yeah, it's in screaming in pain. Yeah. But you are so adorable.
Yeah, well, I've definitely have the cutest car. Thing. So I've got three laps. I reckon I can pull this back.
Yeah, okay, fine.
Look at that. Oh, gosh. It does not handle jumps well. But look at that lovely view.
Yeah,
lovely,
I know. Barely view. Time to enjoy that gorgeous sunset.
Yeah. And the fireworks. I see they've set off some fireworks as well.
They're probably having a great time down on the, I don't know, nearby beach or something.
Yeah, there'll be a beach party, like post-race beach party. There's a bit of sand here, actually. A bit of wet sand. And then
pick up
back
some sand,
onto the mud.
Yeah. Back into the mud.
All right.
All the surfaces.
I'm giving it all I've got. I'm the little car that could.
The little car that could. The little car that maybe could.
Maybe
could
that
not.
Might be able to. The little car that might be able to. I can see the pack up ahead. I'm catching them, I think.
Come on. You just got to believe, little car.
Yeah.
Just got to believe.
Look, they've just slammed into a tree as well.
Yes.
Oh, no, he's driven into me.
Oh, come on,
sabotage.
Ortega.
Absolute sabotage.
Ooh.
All right, here we go. This is challenging. This is the most challenging surface I've had so far, certainly.
Your center of gravity is disturbingly high.
It is, for something so teeny-weeny.
Yeah.
Although Jay Ortega is in a similar car, so
yeah,
I feel like I can
true.
Bully him off the road.
Got a cooler skin, though.
Yeah, it's true. I should really have got myself a good livery. You can do your own custom liveries and things. So
no,
I
of
should
course.
Really have painted this thing up. Next time.
Next time.
All right. Oh, no. Overdid it there.
So much
it. We just stay out of those puddles because I will actually sink. I'm small enough that my ground clearance is so low, I will actually just sink. It's gotten dark
all right,
as well.
Really dueling with Ortega there.
Yeah, here we go. All right, seventh position, lap
go,
two
go,
of three.
Go.
Let's see
Gun
if
it.
We can make
Floor
up any
it.
More places. I'm gunning it. It's being gunned as hard as possible.
Okay. Where's our next competitor up ahead?
Oh, a little ways ahead, yeah.
Gain some ground.
All right, but hopefully
we just need them to stack it into the jungle.
That's true. They may yet do that. It's clearly as challenging for them as it is for me.
I hope so.
All right, here we go. He's coming back at me. Ortega.
Oh, no.
Leave me alone.
Nemesis.
Yeah, he's becoming my nemesis. Right, hopefully there'll just be a bunch of crashed cars in the trees up there.
Yeah, and you can just jump clear over the
leap
top
over
of
them.
Yeah.
I think there is an achievement or something, or something you unlock for doing
for
an overtake
jumping over
the top
car.
Of someone. Yeah. It does happen more frequently than you'd expect.
Awesome.
Through the confetti. Big slide. There's someone. I see someone.
Come on.
I've got to
big
get him.
Big slide. And
it's sort of like skiing this. You're sort of flying down a hill and trying to sort of carve your way around.
Yep.
Oh, come on. They're within sight.
Yeah.
Oh. Avoid that bridge.
Let's overtake them on a jump or something cool like that.
I'm going to try, but I think the start-finish line's just around the corner.
No.
Oh,
no!
So close.
Oh,
seventh position. There we go.
That
oh, my
rough.
Little go-kart. The little car that couldn't, actually.
I feel like it should just fall apart in that ending scene.
All the wheels, like a clown car, yeah. It's called the Speed Car Wonder. Speed Car Wonder is such a cute name as well. It's adorable.
Yeah, that's exactly what that car should be called. But yeah, you and the other Speed Car Wonder placed next to each other, so...
Well, that makes sense. Clearly, that's all that was possible from this.
You were getting the most you could out of that little car.
All right, on to the next extreme weather challenge. I think it's time for a bit of dusty, sandstormy kind of weather. How about that?
Fun! Like that song, A Sandstorm.
Yes, the one that goes do-do-do-do-do.
Yeah, we haven't paid for the licensing, so I won't be singing it.
Yes. Right, let me find
Where are we going?
We're going to Asif Tifnau or something.
It's got giant scorps. Big old scorpions.
Giant scorps. Yeah, you'll be dodging the giant scorps.
Oh, look, that is giant. It's like twice as high as a palm tree.
It's lovely. It's a real whistle-stop tour around the globe. Like,
yeah, I know. It makes me miss
travel. Think of the air miles we're earning.
Yeah.
It is. That is the thing about this this game. It is very much like a holiday, but with lots of cars. And lots of weather. There's so much weather in this game. The sheer volume of weather in this game is enormous.
Okay.
I'm in my like consumer grade, consumer spec Aston Martin DBX here, and I'm racing against a bunch of actual race lorries. We've brought spare tires, which seems like cheating to
me. Yeah, they look big. They look like big bully cars.
Yeah, they do.
Bully you off the road.
I reckon I can take them though. But
why do they need so many tires? Are they planning on changing?
Well, these are vehicles that like would normally be doing sort of, you know, 2 week long rallies. Like
but we're doing like a 3 minute race. I feel like they have disadvantaged themselves by loading
it's
up
additional
on
weight.
Spare tires.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it's they've really screwed it up. but this guy is still beating me. Oh, look, little riverbed.
Oh, cute.
Yeah. Nice. This is
paddle
like
paddle tires. Why it should always be paddle tires?
Yeah, we should always have paddle tires. Oh no, that looks like a big, quite ominous sandstorm coming over the horizon.
Oh,
those balloons are about to be swallowed up by it.
Oh no!
R.I.P. those guys.
Go faster, hot air balloons.
But I have taken the lead.
The sandstorm.
I think the truck was momentarily distracted by the incoming sandstorm.
By the incoming sandstorm.
Yeah.
Oh, sick.
That was a pretty sick jump.
Sweet air. They should have served a meal on that flight, Mike.
Nice. Oh, look, it is really, that's really rolling in.
Oh, yikesy. You think they'd call off the old race, you know, in the middle of a killer sandstorm.
The racing must continue.
Yeah.
All is racing, Jane. In the world of Dirt 5, all is racing.
You're like a shark. If you stop racing, you die.
You die, yeah. This is a proper wall of sand approaching now. It's like that bit in The Mummy. Do you remember The Mummy with Brendan Fraser?
Yeah, if it had a big old mummy face, it would be exactly like that bit in The Mummy.
I mean, we don't know yet. It may yet
You're
have
about
a
to
giant
get swallowed up by a big old sandy mummy face, yeah.
Another
sick
jump.
Oh, here it comes. Say goodbye to your visibility.
Oh,
I assume.
It's really rolling in.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Sorry about it, onlookers, bystanders. They're just getting a lung full of it right now.
Oh, my God, yeah, it'd be horrible there. No face mask or anything on those guys.
No, lungs full of sand.
This is, I'm sure there's a corner in here somewhere, but I can't see
it. Oh, wow. Getting whipped. It's going to take all your paint off. All your paint.
But I'm in the lead. I'm resisting the urge. Oh, he's really close. He's actually really close.
He's right behind you.
Okay. Oh, I need some precision power slides.
Traction.
Slow out that corner. Yeah.
Yep.
Need more traction.
I guess it's probably not hurting the road surface too bad, right? It's just sand.
It might be. Yeah, it's like a light dusting probably. It's not affecting it too much, I don't think. Oh, he's right on my tail.
He wants that position.
I have to give the spectators credit for still sticking around for this one.
They're really dedicated.
I think I'd be diving for cover.
Yeah, it's scrubbing their retinas off them, off their eyeballs right now. This is going to be the last thing they ever see.
Yeah, oh no.
You better make it a good race.
All right, well, I'm about to do a sick jump. If this is the last thing they'll ever see, they'll be pleased about it. Look at that.
Yeah.
The guy landed nearly completely on top of me. Oh, these
and
precision
then,
turns, though. It handles like a dream, this thing.
Yeah.
It handles like an absolute dream.
Okay. It's looking good. And then the Scorpion King comes out and gives you a trophy, I imagine.
Exactly,
giant
yeah. That's what's represented by the race's logo. All right. There was so much scenery to enjoy and admire, and it's all
there's a lot
now,
to look at, isn't there?
In a very dark, very dark cloud of
like an
sand.
Eclipse.
Yeah.
Do you think we're going to come out the other side of the sandstorm at some
point? I don't
know.
We've got another lap, so it might blow over. Yeah, you're
right.
That
would be nice.
It might... seem clearing on that side, but... as challenges go, it's definitely harder than just driving around in the daytime.
Yeah, right. Oh, is he still on your tail? Your nemesis?
He's right there. I can see him on my little map.
Right
Look,
there, I can
there
see.
There he is. He's
deadly
absolutely,
little dot there.
He's like dueling me. You know that film Duel? That Steven Spielberg film. Where that guy gets chased by an evil
truck. That's this.
That's exactly what's happening. The sun seems to be kind of piercing through, though.
Oh, wow.
So it might be clearing up.
It's practically apocalyptic.
It really is, isn't it? Yeah. All right. Okay. Keep going. I've got a good gap. I've got a decent gap. I think I can hold it.
Just maintain.
It's definitely clearing up.
Down
I can see
riverbed.
A bit more.
Yeah.
The sun's really trying to get through. There we go. Practically back to normal. Last few corners. Nice little slide.
Here you go, don't muck it up. And the sun's coming out.
Another big jump.
The sky is practically clear. The surviving bystanders are cheering you on.
The ones who haven't had their retinas sandblasted. Yeah,
nice.
Good. A good result, I think. Well, I've not crossed the line yet. I could still muck it up.
Well, yeah. Yeah, don't count your chickens.
Yeah,
here we
I
go.
Love it. I love counting my chickens. I like to both count my chickens and put all my eggs in one basket for the double
risky
foolish
chicken
metaphor.
Behavior.
Yeah. There you go. Blue skies. I see blue skies.
Yeah. See, we made it after all. It turns out only you and the car behind you are the surviving
Everyone
cars.
Else is dead.
Everyone else got lost in the sandstorm.
Yeah, they're somewhere in the middle of the Sahara.
They were whisked away.
All right, final jump.
I remember this purple smoke, yep.
There you go, and there's the finish line.
Straight under the neon tunnel bit.
Suck it, losers.
Yay!
Nothing if not a bad winner. There you go.
I didn't notice you smash your headlight. Oh, dear.
Oh, I definitely drove into it. It was probably over one of those jumps, to be honest. I probably just nosed it in. All right. Moose came third.
Okay,
Muddy.
Okay, there's old Pierre Bernard.
My nickname is Magic. You know, like Magic Mike.
Magic Mike Channel, yeah.
That's what I do on the side to fund my racing.
Yeah, yeah. Alternate stripping and racing.
Yeah.
Sorry, dancing and racing.
Exotic dancing, we like to call it, Jane. Thank you very much.
Where are we going?
We are going to the East River.
Uh-huh.
For a cheeky icebreaker 80s rally challenge.
Oh, okay.
This is what rally cars look like in the 80s, a.k.a. awesome.
Dope. Was there less sunshine in the 80s? Because that's a lot of headlights.
They used to do it. They used to race in the dark a lot. That's why.
Cool. That's very cool. That's the angriest taxi I ever saw.
Yeah, yeah. So here we go. This is the frozen East River.
Wow.
And we are racing on it in spite of all the many, many cracks that you can see.
Right.
We are happy with this situation and we're going to...
I feel like the East River doesn't freeze over solid very often. This is like, do you remember Day After Tomorrow? The Jake Gyllenhaal vehicle action film.
This game is a lot like racing through the set of Day After Tomorrow, basically.
This is, again, apocalyptic circumstances for this race.
I love it. I love the apocalypse. If it involves this much rally driving, I'm down with it.
If it's a globe-trotting rally tour.
Yeah. So what we will see in this race is a coming snowstorm, essentially.
Oh, okay. On top of the skiddy slidey ice surface.
Exactly.
Okay.
That. But I'm just doing my graceful gliding, figure skating slides
around on here.
I have actually driven on ice, and there are big cracks, and sometimes you'll be just standing there on the ice, and it'll make a really unnerving cracking sound.
Big cracking sound.
But apparently it's fine. As long as you've got about a metre's worth of ice, or maybe 1.5 metres worth of ice, you're fine to drive cars on it, yeah.
Oh, okay.
So they do check. I think they drill a big hole. Look, the weather's really turned. Look, that blizzard's really starting to come in now. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling suddenly extremely Christmassy.
Yeah, sure, why not? It's quite sort of festive, isn't it?
It is, yeah. It's like all those Christmassy movies set in New York.
Yeah.
With the
Home
snow
Alone,
coming down.
The New York one.
Home Alone 2, rallying in New York, I seem to remember it being called.
Yeah, when Kevin McAllister does all that rally driving.
Does an awesome rally driving around on the East River. Wow, it's really, again, the visibility's closed in a bit. I've got snow on my face.
This is challenging
stuff.
Do you have appropriate tyres on for this? Do appropriate tyres even exist for this kind of
Yes, they do,
driving?
Jane. That's a very good question. And the appropriate tyres studded tyres. With little studs in that give you uniform grip across surfaces.
Okay, like football boots.
Yeah, exactly like football boots.
I got it.
But for cars. How am I doing? I'm absolutely dominating
these
guys.
You're nailing it. Yeah.
I'm absolutely ruining them. Snow, clearly my happy place.
Yeah, this is your natural habitat.
It is indeed. Although I've overcooked that slightly, so they'll be coming back at me. There they are.
Uh-oh.
Oh, but it's clearing up. It's fine. The weather's clearing up again.
Oh, that wasn't so extreme. I mean, it is still extreme in that the river is frozen solid.
Yes. But actually, as snowstorms go, it wasn't too bad.
That was acceptable.
Managed it quite fine.
Are we coming up on the old Pepsi-Cola plant again?
Yeah.
It was around this way.
It was indeed. It's got a really nice retro Pepsi-Cola sign, which is lovely. Yeah. But the good thing about driving on ice is that there's no like variation in the grip. It's all the exact same.
It's all terrible.
Yeah, it's all the
it's
exact same amount of
uniformly terrible to drive on. So at least it can't surprise you until you hit like a crack or a hole or something.
There's your Pepsi Cola
sign.
There
it is. That makes me feel sort of Christmassy for some reason. But then it might be because I'm thinking of Coca-Cola, which obviously owns Christmas.
Yeah, they bought it first place. There we go.
I think it may have been because of your camouflage. Your car was all snowy camouflage.
Of course, they couldn't see me.
They can't catch what they can't see.
Exactly, that explains it. Well, Jane, there is one more.
Okay.
There is one more weather condition that is even more
extreme. Can weather get? Tell me.
I've got two words for you.
Right.
Thunder snow. Thunder snow might be one word actually, but it's. You know what thunder snow is, right? It's
no.
When you've got a snowstorm and a thunder and lightning storm at the same time.
Wow. Okay. All right. I should have deduced that from the name, but also no.
Very
I've
rarely
never seen
happens.
Thunder snow.
It is drama in the harbour. Okay.
Okay.
What car shall I pick? I will pick the. Let's give the BMW. Now we are going to Norway, where you will experience the terror of thunder snow.
Ultra cross, yeah.
It looks lovely here at the moment. It's a beautiful thermonuclear sunset going on.
Yeah, it
right
looks
now.
A lot, is what it looks.
Yeah, but we're about to experience what is known as thunder snow. And Jane, it is a weather condition that typically falls in regions of strong upward motion within the cold sector of an extratropical cyclone.
Sure, okay, off the dome. Wait, upward motion? So,
yeah.
Like, okay, fine. Let's just.
Yeah, the
see.
Weather goes up and then it becomes a thunder snow.
Okay.
That's as I understand
snow.
It.
Thunder snow, let's have it.
This is probably. I've played a bit of this career mode in Dirt 5.
Yes.
This is one of the most challenging races. So don't expect an amazing result, but do expect
hey,
thunder snow.
Don't manage my expectations. I'm gunning for a first place from you here.
All right, well, I'll try. I'll try my very best. But things
what a glorious, weird sunset.
It's amazing,
sunset.
Isn't it? Yeah, the sun's low in the sky, I guess, here in the Arctic Circle.
Maybe it's that time of year when the sun doesn't even go down, really. It just
oh, it definitely
just sort
goes down
around the horizon. Oh, it does. It, okay.
It's about to go down.
Oh, I see.
Both literally and figuratively.
Uh-oh.
Things are about to go down. But
oh, dear.
Yeah, so this is another one of those transitions from day into night, but then also night is
thunder snow.
Yeah, I've said it so many times, it's beginning to lose meaning.
It's
yes,
got to happen now.
Thunder snow is coming.
Yeah, like lightning rain. Lightning rain is the normal kind of lightning.
yeah, exactly, yeah.
Okay,
but
well,
thunder snow is abnormal.
We're right in the thick of it with the pack.
We
right
really are, yeah.
Now.
These cars are difficult to drive. They're extremely powerful and they're only like two-wheel drive. They're rear-wheel drive, so...
Okay.
It's really quite difficult to drive.
Oh dear. They're taking chunks out of you.
They really
are.
Your
boot's already loose.
Yeah, it's absolutely mangled. Isn't it?
If you've got anything in the trunk, it's coming out of there soon.
Yeah, those golf clubs or whatever. Whatever BMW drivers put in their trunk. But yeah, look, it's starting to get dark. The wind's whipping up.
A little bit of blue sky all of a sudden.
But it's fading.
But yeah, the sun has dipped below the horizon. It's getting pinkish here, I want to say. The weather is pink.
It's pink.
Sort of
there's
a Dirt 5 a on brand pink sky.
Yeah, there's a pink front coming across on the
man.
Weather.
It's extreme pink weather happening here.
Oh, it's really difficult to get the traction down
in
these cars because they are...
Yeah.
And I've turned off all the driving aids because it's much more fun to slide around with all the driving assists off.
Okay.
In this game. Ooh, okay.
So it's not even four-wheel drive. It's two-wheel drive.
No, two-wheel drive. So it's very slip-slidey.
Yeah.
Doesn't have as much like traction and grip as the four-wheel drive cars are. Lights
are
on.
Ooh. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, it's good. And I can see that I can see the beginnings of a snowstorm happening.
Yeah.
I can see some flecks of snow.
It's all white and grey now. We're strobing through all the colours.
Yeah, we are. All right. Nearly overdid that. Nearly clipped this beautiful stone wall. Which has probably been here for hundreds of years. And it would be a real shame for a rally car to drive into. Right, here we go. I can see all the snowflakes being like illuminated by the headlights.
It's pretty, yeah.
Okay. I'm really, like you say, in the thick of this battle.
Yeah.
I've got cars at all angles.
Yeah.
Oh, colourful lights. All right, okay. It's getting really difficult to drive now because it's dark and snowy. And gosh, this is actually extremely challenging.
I bet this is really intense in first person.
Right
now.
Shall I switch to first person?
Yeah,
like
I
want to
see it. Yes!
So intense. All the snow's coming at me. Oh my gosh.
That's the snow vision I wanted to see right there.
Oh.
That's very intense.
Just can't see a thing.
See
a thing.
You don't have to keep it though. I know it's difficult.
It's all right.
It is intense though. That looks great.
That was the flash
of
lightning.
Oh, is that thunder snow?
Yeah.
There we go. Some
thunder snow happening.
Thunder snow.
So I've got to use those brief moments where the entire thing is illuminated by thunder snow to work out where the heck I'm going, basically.
Right. So you get full vision once every 40 seconds or something.
For a split second.
Nice.
Oh, there's a bit. There's a nice lit tower here. There's the lightning. There's your thunder
snow. Now this is extreme. This is extreme weather. I agree. Yep. I concur.
What am I doing? I'm in 10th place. That's pathetic. That's bad.
I can only
it?
See one car. Oh, no, wait, defense, here comes another one. Here they all come.
They are coming past, aren't they? In my defense, this is the worst weather it is possible to drive in.
Is it?
Pretty confident.
Dear. Oh, man.
I'm going to muscle my way through.
Crunch.
Oh, no, I'm being muscled.
Oh, no.
Stop muscling me. I'm the muscler, not the muscly. Oh, no. All right, stay away from these walls. This is definitely, I think, Dirt 5's ultimate challenge. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah. This combination of cars and conditions is super challenging.
How does it feel? How does it feel driving in thunder snow?
It's difficult because you're trying to look ahead as far ahead as possible to spot your distances, but the car handles extremely badly. 11th. So hashtag not last, but
not dead last,
not
thanks
far
to
off
Mr.
Last.
Ortega. Yeah.
Well, I've been bested by the Dirt 5
that
extreme
was midday.
Weather challenge.
It says midday heavy snow.
Yeah, well, it was. It's,
was
I think it started around midday. And
fair
then
enough.
Ended
what
up
a combo.
Midnight. Wow, look at that lightning. All right, thank you so much for joining us for the Dirt 5 Extreme Weather Challenge. We've been
Extreme.
Outside Xbox. Yeah, thanks for watching this video brought to you by Outside Xbox and sponsor Dirt 5. Like and subscribe if you enjoy it for much more Xbox content, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.